Ladies and gentlemans, welcome to Late Night Thor News Graveyard Shift. This is the first time in, 2 weeks where we haven't had all the marbles on the line. Who puts marbles in a line anyway? Anywho, this is a special episode for all the people in the Northeast going, oh my golly, what is that noise? And that noise is lightning. And then thunder. Technically, lightning is the flashy thing you see. And the loud boom that follows after it is thunder. If you think the lightning happening in the Washington, D.C. Northeast area now is impressive, I'd like you to take a look. Meet up at Mexico. Look at all the lightning happening up and down the volcano range. And let me take this moment to point out that all those crazy freaking wildfires we are seeing are happening up and down the volcano range. I don't know if anyone's put that together. I can only make observations like that late at night when nobody's listening. Okay, what's it talking about? Trust, don't verify. Wait, what? No, I've screwed that up. What are these? I don't know. Trying new maps, because I lost my old map. And then I was like, what? I love my old map. Yes, this is very nonsensical. But yeah, we were tracking this big, giant, massive storm that is going to be dumping rain on the Northeast. So here's our big area in question that everybody woke up on, and they were like, this is the most lightning we've ever heard in one period of time over by Baltimore. Oh, yeah. New month. Who dis? Happy September. That reminds me. I've got a fundraiser going on. I do a fundraiser every single month, so I continue to bring you guys maximum awesome news. If you'd like to contribute to keep Thor News up and running, you can send me a letter in the mail, or you can make a contribution to PayPal, Venmo, Cash App, or Patreon. With 3 days left, I've only got $1,366 left to raise because you guys are continuously, perpetually awesome. So if you would like to contribute, man, I would sure appreciate it. And I'm going to need some small miracles, some medium-sized miracles, and some large miracles between now and rent, which is like the third. And my new apartment manager is like super, super duper out of this world, incredibly attractive. Although I don't think she likes me. Because like 2 months ago, I got a message saying, in the middle of the month, they were like, you didn't pay rent. I was like, look, dude, I paid rent. And then 2 months later, I got a thing saying, you didn't pay rent in the middle of the month when I paid rent. And I went down there and I videotaped me putting like the rent in the envelope and then me putting it in the slot in the thing just in case crazy shit like that happens. Because I'm a naturally paranoid person because, man, hackers and shit has been wild since 2015. Anyway, it's just crazy. What was I talking about? Oh, yeah. So all this rain. This is going to be dumping rain. We are talking anywhere from 4 to over 10 inches in some parts around these areas. So we are just tracking this storm. This is the remnants of Hurricane Ida. Once again, I want to say I'm so proud of Louisianians, Cajuns, because like only 3 people died from getting hit by a Category 4 hurricane. We've gotten so much better at natural disaster response in the USA, even wildfires. Now, if we can work on our plague game, then I'll be super happy as your planetary defense commander. And if you were wondering which way the wind is blowing, boy, do I have a treat for you. It's blowing that way. Man, it looks like they're throwing all their harp nuggets up in the Dakotas. Okay, I'm trying to crack jokes because to get through the plague, I've been having to watch like every sitcom ever that was good multiple times. And now I'm rewatching Comedians in Cars Getting Coffee with Jerry Seinfeld. And so I have these urges to tell these jokes that would probably get me in trouble now that were okay in 2015. I don't know, man. Yeah, I don't want to do that, though. I guess I'll just try and be funny in a very PG sense all the time. You know, like Bill Cosby used to be before he got arrested and thrown in jail for being way too rapey. But then they let him out for no reason. That was so weird. Okay, so they let out Bill Cosby, who by all intents and purposes should have been in jail. I mean, like, even Tina Fey made a joke in, like, 2010 about how rapey he was on 30 Rock. And then they let out Robert Kennedy's killer. They're like, yeah, after 30 years, we're like, you know what? You don't deserve probation. And they're like, yeah, we changed your mind. In days like today, we think it's best to let out people that are like, hey, if you murder someone super famous and a politician, we'll show that we can be forgiving. Although we can't be forgiving about other shit. I don't know. What I'm trying to say is society's really weird these days, man. Okay, so I talked my game, you know, and I make these grand, bold predictions. So for months, I was like, yo, bros and ladies and ma'ams and aliens and dimensional creatures. And, you know, when they combine digital currency with testicle and vulva stuff that creates like a digital human thingy. That joke went off right on the rails. Anyway, what was I talking about? I totally forgot. Hey, fan proof of your mini ass age. It's up here. I mean, who in the hell's ever heard of snow in September? Not me. Never heard of that shit. Okay, so it's hot down here. It's cooler up here. And it's milder in the middle. That's what she said. Now I'm trying too hard. I don't know. But Yoda said, don't try. He said, just do it. No, was that Nike? Yeah, we live in crazy times. What was I trying to tell a joke about? Bill Cosby and Kennedy's murderer. And then I went off the rails. Whoa, there's these right angles, man. They get to me. They're harping everything. And they're chemtrailing. That's why, like, you ever had chemtrail diarrhea? Ooh, look at that one. That's the one come off Africa. Oh, yeah. See, I like to slip in some serious heavy shit in between all the, like, forced jokes. So you ready for that shit, man? Because it's coming at you. All right, so I still have a problem because, like, you know, I just try to process all the shit. Well, that's beautiful. This is the stuff you come to Thor News for. The beautifulness. Wow. Let's watch this together. You and I. All right, so I'll dial it up. Since only like 12 people are going to watch this video. Okay, so, you know, Ida, this is where I'm kind of freaked out on. Here's the deal, man. I'm tough, I'm smart, I'm cool, and I'm funny. And when I make a mistake, I admit it. And so I feel like I like to do a super job. Well, I mean, I know that. And I usually like to give people like a 10-day advance warning on a hurricane. Now, I like to give the date of when it's coming and the location sometimes. The location's harder. I don't think people remember, and people really haven't talked about how little advanced warning Louisiana got. Because I remember I was like, red alert, red alert, red alert for Ida. And for a while, they were like head faking. They were like, it's coming to lower Texas. And I thought I was going to like Starbase. And so even to the 24th, I was like, everybody in Texas, red alert. You guys need to be prepared. And then like on the 25th, bang, it was in Louisiana. And then 4 days later, it hit. And remember, they were like, we don't even have enough time to set up contraflow because we didn't have advanced warning. And then everybody in, like, all the meteorology or the Twitter is like, what are you talking about? We gave you guys plenty of advanced warning. And then, so, like, meteorology, you know, I don't know. I'm just saying something felt really off on this hurricane. And so now, and I felt like I made a mistake by saying, hey, maybe I got too optimistic about atmospheric defense team. Maybe we'll only get hit by tropical storms. I didn't say that was going to happen 100%, but I was like hoping. And so, I don't know. I'm just saying the whole thing about this one was weird. And it's why I'm very paranoid about the 10th or 9th of September. Now the models have taken away the hurricanes again. What I'm trying to say is we really only got like 4 days warning on this thing. And so for the rest of hurricane season, at least through September and October, I'm going to be super overly cautious, if you guys don't mind. And, dude, the fires have been raging. And like I said, usually they're raging right over volcano areas. But they're fires. SJSU Fire Weather Research Laboratory says its experimental forecast for caldera fires shows weak to moderate progression overnight based on weather forecast and latest fire perimeter. The fires have been bad. And this is the first time that a fire has jumped from, like, California into Nevada, or second time in history, if what I read was correct somewhere. And they've closed all national parks, which is very interesting. But like I said, people in the Northeast are like, oh my God, it's the end of the world. This is the craziest lightning storm we've ever seen. Or I'm exaggerating a little for comedic effect. And somebody's going to be like, I didn't like everything you said. You're a dick. Probably. I'm like, you know what, man? That is illegal because these are the late night cool down broadcasts. So everybody's supposed to be chill. So if you are not chill during these late night broadcasts, you have broken the rules. Not me, man. And so, yeah, lives, we did well in human lives, but man, property got crushed in Louisiana. And between us, yeah, I think they shifted it from Texas to Louisiana. I mean, if somebody had to take the bullet, it seems like Louisiana is the one who usually has to take the bullet. I don't make the calls, man. I'm just calling it like I see it. And so remember when I was like warning everybody, oh my God, the second half of August is just going to be like everything is ending. Everything is out of control. It's pure chaos, death, destruction, wildfires, hurricanes, plagues, everybody arguing with each other, everybody all the time. Now we're going to get an ease down of energy, which I can finally feel until like the end of September. And then Mercury goes retrograde. And then from like the 25th of September, it's going to start to go super crazy again until like the 15th of October. It's going to be like that crazy. It's going to be like the second half of August again. So it's going to be totally sucks. So what I'm trying to tell you is please try and enjoy life as much as you can over the next 3 weeks, because that part of October is going to be wild. And then November and December are going to be wild. And then we're going to party in 2022. Well, in the spring. And please remember, I gave up having a wife, having kids, having family, having good times, being a normal human being, so I could train y'all for 8.5 years on how to be total badasses, emotionally, mentally, spiritually prepared to deal with whatever came our way. You know what I'm saying? I know I wasn't perfect, but I think I've done a good job. And these definitely look like volcanoes. They're not. They're just happening over the volcano ranges. She's a Sagittarius. Like me. Yep, lots of rain. You've seen the storms I'm showing to you. And you know what's pretty cool is like the majority of y'all have been with me for quite a while. And so you know that like every month I do a fundraiser to pay my bills, pay rent, keep everything up and running. And so it is like a weird game show aspect that has its ups and its downs, but ultimately I really enjoy it. It's always very exciting. And so what I'm trying to say is that you got monsoonal moisture coming into the north, parts of states where the south side used to be. Okay, I didn't say that well at all. You got to watch out for burn scar flooding, mudslides, possible travel delays. And man, I feel like I have sure changed over the last 8 years in many ways. Like, I don't know, like we had 3 people die in Hurricane Ida, but yesterday we had 1,394 people die of the coronavirus, which is just so crazy. And it's that thing where people get upset if you throw like a show at 384-hour GFS with a hurricane landfall. Meteorologists lose their mind. And I want to remind you, like, no one's ever died from a 384 GFS. And Asteroid Fight Club is like been around long enough to know that if I'm showing you something from 2 weeks out, we all know that that doesn't mean it's definitely going to hit even 7 days out. I don't know, man. I guess they just don't trust the people who watch their information as much as I do. But it is crazy how much everybody's split down the middle in the damn virus. And I want to say again, I don't support forced vaccinations in any way, shape, or form. Like, if you don't want to get the vax, well, that's fine. I mean, I recommend you wear a mask. And I'm sorry I called y'all the people who don't wear masks pussies. Oh, yeah, I shouldn't have mentioned that again. Oh, yeah, here was the information. It was only the second time officials said that a wildfire that began on the western slopes of the Sierra Nevada crossed into an eastern side. The first was also this summer, the Dixie Fire, the second largest in California. Yeah, you used to be able to call people pussies in, like, 2015. Now you can't get away with that shit. Well, unless it's, like, 3:43 in the morning. And I only called non-mask wearers that because I love you and I care about you. BG Weather Given there has and will be a lot of rainfall, roots and trees that will be very susceptible, so power outages are definitely possible for some areas, but now I don't think they will be widespread and will be contained closer to the coast if they do happen. Hopefully, y'all stay safe. Boom. I feel like I was doing great on this video, and then I went too far. Oh no. Such is the story. Okay. But yeah, we're watching all the things. But the main hurricane point is that landfalling hurricanes, even the hint of them hitting the United States, have fallen off the map. But I don't trust that. Like I was trying to say before, we only got like 4.5 days notice with Ida. So I'm going to try and do a better job. And we just need to be on the lookout for shit popping up out of nowhere. You know what I'm saying? It's like a straight line. It's like the cyclonic equator, I guess. Yeah, don't be surprised if in a week or two, you just got a bunch of these thingies on the board again. But who knows, man? Who can predict the future? Oh yeah, hey Canada, you've been getting hit with storms too. Plus hail. Talking to you, Regina. That's right, that's how you pronounce that word. It's Regina. I don't know if you knew that. You do now. Is it pink? Is it purple? Colorblind people may never know. If I had to give myself a report card, though, I would give myself an A+ for effort for July and August. Those are two super crazy wild months, man. And I did my best. I definitely showed up every day. Oh, speaking of that, be prepared if it's sometime during September I take a day or even two in a row off, you know, before the craziness of October and September and November, December. I guess October's November, December. Yeah, so I might even take 3 days off. Well, if you guys will allow me. You guys are slave drivers. But, you know, I like kicking ass. Even though the Google YouTube system algorithm doesn't seem to like me that much. All right, here you go. Your late night video from me to you, heart to heart. Hopefully I made you laugh once. And hopefully I've inspired you enough to be like, you know what? Thor deserves to stick around for at least another month. Maybe even close out the year. You can help make that happen with a contribution for this September fundraiser. I've only got $1,366 left to go. That may sound like a lot, but $1,777 sounds like a lot. And we're like a third of the way there. Or maybe is it a fourth? I don't know. I'm bad at math. Anyway, you can send it to my mailbox, my PayPal, my Venmo, my Cash App, my Patron, and ask for a fight club. Seriously, you guys have been incredible, and you guys treat me well, and I love y'all. That's why I give my all. So thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you to Mike for healing. Thank you to Tracy. Thank you to Lauren. Thank you to Nancy. Thank you to the Pink Wolf Girl. Thank you to Dave. Thank you to Cody. Thank you to Greg. Thank you to John. Thank you to Jamie. Thank you to Mad Motifs. Thank you to Andrea. Thank you to Darlene. Thank you to Ed. And thank you to everybody out there. Hashtag Team Maderna. 24-year-old Chloe Mrazek from Illinois was arrested after allegedly using this fake COVID-19 vaccine card to enter Hawaii and avoid travel restrictions. Said Maderna instead of Moderna. Oh, and you can almost see the Alex Jones behind your eyes. That same rage look. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, be careful when you buy Maderna tickets. I'm a proud member of hashtag Team Moderna. I still no side effects. But you do you. Like I said, I support vaccine choices. So, no, but I'm saying play defense until spring of 2022. But you can do whatever you want to do. Life is like a weird experiment. All right. I'm your Planetary Defense Commander, Star-Lord New Thor 7. Let's have a great week. And let's have a great month. Okay? Sounds great. I love you. Stay cool. God bless everyone.